The Life of Carlisle Cullen. Carlisle Cullen was born in 1640 in London, England, and is the founder and leader of the Olympic Coven. He is the second husband of Esme Cullen and the adoptive father of Emmett, Alice, Edward Cullen, and Jasper and Rosalie Hale. He is also the adoptive father-in-law of Bella Swan and the adoptive grandfather of Renesmee Cullen. In his human life, Carlisle was very compassionate. When he was turned, this manifested into unparalleled compassion that allowed him to perfect his lifestyle as a vegetarian among vampires, to the point that he is able to completely resist the temptation of human blood, even if it is in large amounts, and pass this restraint to his family. Welcome to the Amagi. In today's video, we're going over the life of Carlisle Cullen. Before we begin, we publish new content every week, so be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. Early life. Carlisle Cullen was the son of an Anglican pastor. He was born sometime in 1640 in London during a time of religious and political upheaval. His mother died giving birth to him. Carlisle's father and other pastors led hunts for werewolves, witches, and vampires, claiming that they were attempting to rid the world of evil and sin. Many a time, however, these groups would end up killing innocent citizens. As his father aged, Carlisle took over the raids. He was less at ease about killing as his father was, but he was intelligent enough to find a real coven of vampires inhabiting the sewers of London. Carlisle led the hunt after them, and in the chaos that ensued, he was attacked and left bleeding in the street by a vampire. Knowing what his father would do, Carlisle hid in a potato cellar for his painful transformation, emerging 3 days later as a vampire. Carlisle was repelled and horrified by what he had become, and tried various ways of killing himself, including starvation, drowning, and jumping off of cliffs. Eventually, he was so desperate for blood that while he was hiding in a cave in a forest, he attacked and fed on a herd of passing deer. He found that he could survive off animal blood, and he considered this much more humane than drinking the blood of a human, thereby killing them. Carlisle found new life in this fact, and over the course of about 2 centuries was able to perfect his ability to resist the bloodlust caused by the scent of human blood. During these 2 centuries, Carlisle studied at night, becoming a nighttime patron of the arts. As a result of his meticulous studying, Carlisle was able to become a brilliant doctor. One of the first vampires he met after his transformation was Alistair, who completely shunned company. But because Carlisle had been lonely for centuries, he'd managed to make Alistair respond a little bit before they parted ways on odd terms. Carlisle was studying in Italy when he stumbled across the Volturi, the dominant vampire coven that was led by 3 vampires named Arrow, Marcus, and Caius. They were much more educated and refined than those living in the sewers of London, but still lived on human blood. While they attempted to convert Carlisle to his natural food source, their attempts were unsuccessful. After living with the Volturi for 2 decades, Carlisle moved on to the New World, where he became a doctor and used his skills to help people. In 1911, Carlisle worked as a doctor in Columbus. Because the local doctor was away, he was assigned to treat Esme Ann Platt, a young teenager at the time, after she broke her leg falling out of a tree. They felt a strong mutual attraction even though their encounter was brief. Though he had found out ways to use his skills for good, he did not find what he was searching for, a companion who shared his philosophy and value for human life. His loneliness increased over the years, and eventually he began considering creating a companion of his own. However, the idea of cursing someone else with the same life as him repulsed him. In 1918, Carlisle worked night shifts in a Chicago hospital during the Spanish influenza epidemic. During the epidemic, Carlisle encountered a dying woman named Elizabeth Mason. Her son, Edward, was dying of influenza as well. Elizabeth Mason begged Carlisle to do anything within his power to save her son as she lay dying. Out of loneliness and armed with the knowledge that Edward was alone in the world, he changed him, making him his companion. The two started traveling together using the cover story that Edward was the younger brother of Carlisle's late wife. Not long after, in 1921, Carlisle and Edward moved to Ashland, Wisconsin, where Carlisle was called to the bedside of a dying woman. He was surprised when he found out that the woman was Esme, who suffered injuries from a failed suicide attempt spurred by the loss of her child. Remembering her as the ever so happy young girl he met before, and unable to believe that someone as vivacious and beautiful as she would meet such a cruel fate, he changed her into a vampire to save her life. He then explained to Esme about what he had done to save her. To his surprise, she was not upset by his decision. She too remembered their first meeting and had always considered Carlisle her ideal of a gentleman. They soon fell in love and married. Carlisle then turned Rosalie Hale, a young woman who was raped and almost killed by her drunken fiancé and his friends before leaving her in the street to die. Carlisle hoped for Rosalie to become Edward's mate, but they were never more than siblings to each other. 2 years later, while hunting, Rosalie found a young man named Emmett McCarty who had been mauled by a bear. She carried him over 100 miles back to Carlisle to be changed. Around 1950, Mary Alice Brandon and Jasper Whitlock joined his coven. Alice and Jasper met in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania in 1948, and sought out the Cullens based on Alice's visions. Rosalie and Jasper pose as twins, taking the surname Hale for their time in Forks, while Alice changed her name to Cullen. Much later, Carlisle and his family moved to Forks, Washington, where they had lived before and made a treaty with the Quileute tribe, led by a shapeshifter named Ephraim Black. The treaty stated that the Quileutes would leave the Cullens alone and not reveal them to humans if the Cullens would refrain from biting humans, whether to kill or change them, or trespassing on Quileute land. Because of the treaty, the Cullens were able to live in relative peace. Twilight. At the start of Twilight, the Cullens have lived in Forks, Washington for 2 years. Carlisle currently works at Forks Hospital, becoming their chief doctor. With his riches that he had accumulated as a successful doctor over 2 centuries, he bought his black Mercedes S55 AMG. After his adoptive son Edward saved Bella Swan from being crushed by Tyler Crowley's van that spun out of control, Carlisle treats her. Edward later begins to fall in love with Bella despite his attempts to stay away from her because of his lust for her blood. Bella eventually reciprocates Edward's feelings. Carlisle is happy to see that Edward, who is the only member of his family who hasn't found love, has finally found someone. During this time, another coven of vampires sweeps into Forks. When one of them, James, decides to hunt Bella, Carlisle joins his family in hunting James before he can hurt Bella. Bella and the Cullens split up. Alice and Jasper take Bella to Phoenix, Arizona. Esme and Rosalie remain in Forks to protect Charlie, Bella's father, and Emmett, Edward, and Carlisle hunt James. James eventually goes to Phoenix and lures Bella out of hiding, but is killed by Emmett and Jasper. James still manages to hurt Bella. She suffers a broken leg, broken ribs, many cuts, and a bite on her hand. After Edward sucked the venom from her, she is able to recover with the help of Carlisle. New Moon. Carlisle treats Bella in New Moon after she cut her arm when Edward shoved her into a wall filled with glass to protect her from a bloodthirsty Jasper. Bella questions Carlisle on how he can withstand the smell of her blood when the others have a hard time being around her. Carlisle responds by saying it is possible because he enjoys what he does and is pleased when his enhanced abilities help save someone who would otherwise have been gone. Sometime after this, Edward leaves Bella, claiming he no longer wanted her, and their family relocates to Ithaca, New York. In reality, Edward, deeply conflicted, does so to ensure her safety and still loving her completely. During this time, Carlisle works night shifts and teaches part-time at Cornell, where Jasper studies philosophy. 6 months later, Edward came to believe Bella was dead and went to Italy to ask the Volturi to kill him. Alice and Bella were able to find him in time. However, the Volturi said that Bella either had to become a vampire or be silenced permanently, for she knew too much about the vampire world. Carlisle and his family meet Edward, Alice, and Bella at the airport after Bella stops Edward from his suicide mission. He offers his joy and gratitude to Bella for saving Edward. Later, when Bella asks the Cullens if she should join them, he gives his vote in favor of turning her into a vampire, even saying he will do it himself after Bella's graduation, though Edward, who is originally against the idea, agrees to do it himself if Bella would marry him first. His family moves back to Forks and Carlisle is quickly accepted by his old staff. Eclipse. At the start of Eclipse, a string of unsolved murders are happening in Seattle, not far from Forks. But Carlisle and the rest of the Cullens, after hearing the news about them, know that vampires are behind it. Eventually, they realize that someone is creating an army of newborn vampires. When the Cullens' closest allies, the Denali Coven, abandon them, Carlisle and his family form an unlikely alliance with the Quileute werewolves. The vampire behind the newborns turns out to be Victoria, James' mate. Her army is destroyed by the combined forces of the Cullens and the pack of Quileute werewolves, while Victoria herself is beheaded by Edward when she makes an attempt on Bella's life during the battle. While this goes on, Jacob is hurt at the clearing when he tries to protect Leah Clearwater from a newborn. Carlisle treats Jacob's wounds as they would not be able to take him to a normal doctor. After getting Jacob to phase back into human form, they take him back to his house and Carlisle is forced to re-break Jacob's injuries as his bones had healed crooked and out of line. Jacob is hostile towards Carlisle as he treats him, but Bella tells Jacob to just accept Carlisle's advice. It's while Carlisle is treating Jacob that he takes a blood sample and does tests with it, on the claim that he is fascinated by werewolves. It is then that he finds out that werewolves have 24 pairs of chromosomes, one more pair than a human and one less than a vampire. Breaking Dawn. In Breaking Dawn, Carlisle attends Edward and Bella's wedding. After the wedding, Bella and Edward go to their honeymoon place, Isle Esme, which Carlisle gave to Esme as a wedding gift. During the honeymoon, Alice calls Edward, but Bella answers the phone instead. Bella then asks to speak to Carlisle, hoping that he could help her understand what was happening. Bella tells Carlisle that she might be pregnant, and after being informed of her symptoms, Carlisle agrees. Edward brings Bella back to Forks so Carlisle can perform an abortion, but Bella already feels a bond with her unborn child and insists on giving birth. When Edward is talking to Jacob, he tells him that Carlisle would have gone along with him in aborting the hybrid, but Esme was against it and Carlisle would not go against her. After Bella gives birth to Renesmee and becomes a vampire, Carlisle and the entire family immediately become attached to the newborn baby. Renesmee also leads to the treaty with the werewolves to a stronger bond when Jacob Black imprints on her. Carlisle is very impressed with Bella's ability to restrain control over her thirst and emotions, which is something that most newborns are unable to do. When the Volturi hear of Renesmee from Irina, they believe she is an immortal child and gather the entire guard and wives and witnesses to destroy Carlisle and his entire family. Carlisle is saddened that Alice and Jasper have left them but respects their decision. Over the month it takes for the Volturi to arrive, Carlisle and the other Cullens gather a number of witnesses of their own to testify that Renesmee is not an immortal child. He also persuades his Irish friend Siobhan to visualize a peaceful situation with the Volturi because he suspects she has an undiscovered talent of manipulating reality. In Alice's vision, he is killed by Arrow, who rips off his head, while trying to save Alice from being captured. His body is then lit on fire while Arrow stands smiling and holding his head. This spurs the Cullens and witnesses into action and they charge and the battle begins. In the end, the battle is avoided and Carlisle's doom is prevented. With the help from Nahuel's witness, the wolves, and Bella's mental shield, their efforts are successful and the Volturi retreat in fear. Carlisle and his family's allies suspect that the Volturi may attempt to avenge their humiliation in the future, and Carlisle says they will stand against them again if that time comes. Did you enjoy our video? Be sure to check out these other great videos from the Amagi, and make sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.